Hello, in this tutorial I'll show how to run a steady state simulation in COPASI. A steady state is a condition in which all of the species concentrations do not change with time. This happens when all of the reaction rates consuming the species are in balance with the reaction rates producing them. There are two main methods for finding steady states. One is the Newton method. It is very fast but not guaranteed to converge. The other main method is to integrate the time course until all of the concentrations stop changing. This is guaranteed to converge for stable steady states, but is slow. Integrating time courses backwards in time is another method. This is rarely used, but is useful for some systems. By default, COPASI uses all three methods in that order, but the user can control which of these are used. Let's load a MAPK cascade model. Click the triangle to expand the tasks tree. Then select steady state. Let's set these to 0 to try and find a steady state with only the Newton method, and click run. Click result here to show the result window. This message reports a steady state was not found using only the Newton method. This is also evident under the Species tab in the Rate column, where many of these rates are far from zero. The Protocol tab gives a summary of the steps taken. The Newton method ultimately failed to find a steady state. Let's include integration and retry. This time, a steady state was found. Now, all the species rates are near or at zero. In the Protocol tab, here is the point at which a steady state was found. Having all negative values for the reduced Jacobian indicates this steady state is stable. Indeed, under the Stability tab, this state is summarized as being asymptotically stable. Let's update this model to start at this steady state and take a look at a time course plot. Time course and basic plotting are covered in the Time Course tutorial video. Go to the Time Course task and click Output Assistant to create a basic concentration plot. This plot now appears under Output Specifications. Because it is active, it will appear after the next simulation run. Run the time course. The species concentrations do appear to have reached steady state in this 100-second time course. We'll next look at a model with an unstable steady state. But first, I'd like to illustrate the difference between a stable and unstable steady state. If we place a ball at the bottom of a well, it should remain at that spot. This is a steady state. This steady state is stable because the placement of the ball at any point would result in it moving back to this bottom point. Now it is also possible to balance a ball at the top of this hill. This is also a steady state. But it is unstable because movement in one or more directions away from this point will not result in a return to here. Let's load the Brucellator model to show this. A time course plot shows the behavior of this system. Now let's see if COPASI can find a steady state. Yes, a steady state with the given resolution was found. But the reduced Jacobian reveals one or more positive eigenvalues. Indeed, the stability summary indicates that it is unstable. Now let's update model and start a time course from this steady state point. We see it starts off with steady concentrations, but then falls back into its original behavior. This concludes the COPASI tutorial on steady state. Thank you for using COPASI.